Good day, students. In this video, we are going to see how we can simulate series resonance phenomena in an oral C circuit using PC. Right? So, before simulating using PC, let us understand the basics of the series resonance circuit. So, in the series resonance circuit, we are going to have a resistor, an inductor, and a capacitor. So, it is a series RLC circuit. And this is R, this is L, and this is C. So, this is the AC power supply which will be going to have a frequency, right? So, the impedance to the circuit is depend upon this frequency. So, if I want to calculate the current will be equal to the ratio of voltage to impedance. So, what about impedance in the circuit? So, impedance in the circuit will be given by R plus J XL minus XC. So, this is what we already know in any RLC circuit, the impedance will be given by this formula. So, XL will be equal to 2 pi FL or omega L and XC is equal to 1 by 2 pi FC. Okay? So, this reactances of the inductance and capacitor is going to continuously vary with respect to the frequency. So, if frequency changes, these reactances are going to change, right? So, when the maximum value of current will be existing in the circuit? When we are having very lowest impedance. So, when impedance is very much lower, we will be getting a high current flowing through the circuit. So, when this impedance can be lower? So, when it has only resistive component and if it has no reactive components. So, if there is no reactance, this component should be equal to 0. So, we want this XL minus XC component should be equal to 0. It implies what is our requirement is at some particular frequency, this reactance will be equal to this reactance, right? So, if these two reactances are equal, then the circuit is offering very low impedance and very high current. So, we are finding that F, which is normally called as resonant frequency of the series RLC circuit. So, this FR will be equal to 1 by 2 pi root of LC after simplification, right? So, this is the resonant frequency of the circuit. So, for our simulation example, let me consider some simple values I am considering some R value is equal to 100 ohms and L value is equal to 1 millihenry, which is equal to 0.001 henry, and I am assuming C is equal to 1 microfarad is equal to 0.000001 farad, right? If I assume these values, then if I want to simulate this RLC series circuit, resonant circuit, first I need to calculate the resonant frequency. Resonant frequency is equal to 1 by 2 pi root of LC and after substituting these values, I will be getting 10 power minus 3 into 1 to 10 power minus 6. So, when I solve this one, I will be nearly getting, do the calculation. So, when I try to solve this one, I am getting 5032, right? So, nearly 5033. So, it is somewhat equal to 5033. So, this is the resonant frequency of this particular circuit. So, 5033. So, here to simulate the circuit, what I am going to do is I am going to open the PC. And I am going to open a new file and I am going to connect all the components. So, I am going to connect a AC supply and a resistor, an inductor and a capacitor, right? So, I want to measure the current through the circuit. So, I am connecting the ammeter and I am taking the wire and I am completing the circuit. So, the circuit is completed and I am connecting the ground. So, now I need to fix the values for all the components in the circuit. So let me open the AC source. So let me fix the peak amplitude as 100. So now peak amplitude is 100. Now what is the frequency? So our resonant frequency is 5000. So we may start from some lower frequencies up to some higher frequencies. So for different frequencies, we are going to see the response of this circuit, right? So let us assume from 1000 hertz. That is, as the resonant frequency is nearly equal to 5 kilohertz, that is 5000. I just want to note down the current values from 1000 hertz, 2000, 3000, 4000, 5000 and up to some 10,000 to get a very good graph for resonance. So, I am just starting from the frequency of 1000 hertz, right. So, I am going to fix this resistor value as 100 and I am going to fix this inductor value as 0.001. And the capacitor value I am fixing is 1 microfarad, right. So, 5 zeros and 1, it represents 1 microfarad. So, I am fixing all these values. Now, I am just going to simulate. So, before simulating, you can control the simulation using simulation control. So, if I am using a simulation control, you can vary the data points that you can simulate. So, that is step size. So, total time is how much time we need to run the simulation. That is total time, right? So, this total time divided by this step size will be your total data points, right? And as it is a demo version, it will allow us to use up to 6000 data points, right? So, if you use a very short time step or if you use a very long total time, then automatically it will truncate the data. So, totally 6000 data points is allowed. So, accordingly you can set your parameters. So, now I am simulating. So, select simulate and run simulation. Then I am visualizing the current values, right. So, it is a AC waveform and it is the current also, it is a sinusoidal waveform. So, I am just clicking the RMS value to see the RMS value of this circuit. So, for 1 kilohertz, the RMS value I am getting is about 3.8 into 10 power minus 1 amperes, that is 0.38 amperes. So, what I am trying to do is, I am just want to record this particular thing in as a graphical data. So, what I am doing is, I am going to change the frequency and I am going to monitor the current. So, frequency in hertz and current in amperes. So, I am going to get so many readings. So, my first reading is, I have done it for 1000 kilohertz and I have taken a reading of 383 amperes, right. So, I am closing this simulation. And my circuit is, so here in the circuit, then I am going to vary the frequency. So, now I am varying the frequency to 2000 and again I am simulating, right. So, now I am checking the RMS value. Now, it is about 5.8 into 10 power minus 1 amperes, that is 0.584 amperes. So, what I am trying to do is, I am just want to record that. So, for 2000 hertz, the reading is 0.584 amps. So, similarly for 3000, 4000, 5000. So, you can take too many readings, right. So, as our frequency is about 5033, directly what I am going to do is, I am going to check for the resonant frequency. So, at 5033, it is a maximum current should be shown in the circuit, right. So, I am setting that particular frequency to 5033. So, at this frequency, the maximum current will be flowing. So, let me check that one. So, I am running the simulation and checking the RMS value. The RMS value is about 7.06 into 10 power minus 1, that is 0.7 amperes. So, what I am getting here is, the maximum value I am getting is somewhat 0.5 707. So why I am getting this amperes? If you see, the maximum amplitude, so peak amplitude I am set in the circuit, peak voltage I have set in the circuit is 100 volts. So this is the maximum peak value. So what will be the RMS value of the voltage? So it will be equal to 100 by root 2. So it will be equal to some 70.7 volts. So RMS voltage of supply will be like this. So what is the current? So at resonance, current is equal to the voltage divided by only R, because there is no reactive components, reactance component, reactance will be cancelling. So we are having only resistance. So this 70.7, our resistor value is 100. So we are getting 0.707 amperes at resonance. So this is the maximum current you can see in this circuit, right? And you can continue this experiment by varying this frequency to up to nearly 30 kilohertz you can do, to 30,000 hertz you can take the readings and you can tabulate the readings, right? After tabulating the readings, so if you see, let me see whether this current is getting decreased for the other frequencies. So let me change the to 5033 resonant frequency to 6000, and if I simulate the circuit, the RMS value is 0.701, right? So definitely it is getting reduced. So it is start reducing. So it will be going on reduced. So this is the resonant frequency, and in this resonant point, maximum current occurs. Right? So after a while, we are taking all these readings. What I am going to see is, I am going to draw the resonant curve. So to draw the resonant curve, I am going to open the Excel. So I am going to open the Excel. Now what I am doing is, I am recording all my frequency and current. So my frequency is in the unit of hertz. My current is in the unit of amperes, right? So for the different data, for different simulated data, I have obtained the current through this circuit. So I have started the simulation from 250 hertz up to 30,000 hertz, right? So these are, you can take as many as simulated data. And now what I am going to do is, I want to draw the graph. So I am going to select these X and Y values, right? And I am going to insert. So click insert a chart. So I am going to insert a scatter chart. So if I insert a scatter chart, I will be getting a graph like this, and this graph is a linear graph. This graph is a linear graph. If you see the x-axis is very linear, right? But to understand the resonance phenomena, we need to draw the graph in semi-logarithmic graph, right? So, to see the resonance accurately, what I am going to do is, I am going to change this axis. So, for that, I am clicking the chart to get the format chart area. So, in the format chart area, I am just clicking the size and properties, and I am clicking the horizontal axis. So I want to change the horizontal axis, right? Then I am clicking this axis option, because I want to change the x axis to as a logarithmic axis. So axis options, and if I click the axis option and I drag it down, I will be getting a point called logarithmic scale. So I am going to click that logarithmic scale. So, if logarithmic scale is fixed, this graph will be converted as a semi-log graph. So, if you see the graph, you can accurately see the performance of the resonance in RLC series circuit, right? So, to get more data points, you can do this experiment for more frequencies, and you can get this accurate resonance curve, right? Hope you understand how to work with this experiment, right? Right. Thank you. Thank you for listening.